question, we are looking at a falling object that experiences a resistance that is proportional to velocity. Part A, we need to explain why the acceleration of the object is given by this linear differential equation, dv to t equals g minus kv. Let's draw a quick diagram. Here's the object, and the object falls under the force of gravity, which we'll denote by g. And we'll also note that we define the positive direction of motion to be downwards. The falling object experiences resistance. Resistance is acting in the opposite direction to gravity. I'll call it R. And in part A, the resistance is defined to be proportional to velocity. So we can define R to be some constant times V. Let's write the equation of the forces. We have the acceleration, which is defined to be the rate of change of velocity with respect to time, which is equal to G minus K times V, which is what the question requires. As a final note, this is not a typical question that you'll get in an examination, but we're looking at it here just to set the problem up. Now that we've set the question up, we're going to solve this linear differential equation. So, we're now going to solve this equation to find an expression for the velocity of the object. The first thing I'll do is move the V terms to the left-hand side. You can see clearly that I have a linear differential equation in terms of V here, and the method of solution will involve determining an integrating factor we'll call H of T. I'll put that here on the right. H of t will define to be e to the power of the integral of the coefficient of v with respect to time, which is e to the k t. Once I have my integrating factor, I'm going to multiply my differential equation throughout by that term. And note that the left-hand side can be rewritten as the derivative with respect to time of e to the kt times v. And I always like to check, just mentally even, that this expression here represents the line above. At this point, we'll integrate both sides with respect to t. So integrating this exponential function gives me a g on k, e to the k t. And we have to use our initial conditions. Our initial condition is that when t is zero, the velocity is zero. I'm going to write that here on the right-hand side, and substitute this information into my differential equation. So on the left-hand side I have zero, on the right, oops, I forgot my constant of integration here, that's what we're solving for. On the left-hand side I have zero, e to the power of zero is one, so I have g on k plus c. That gives me a value of c of minus g on k. At this point, I'll substitute my value for c into my equation. So I have e to the kt times v equals g on k e to the kt minus 1. And tidying up, multiplying throughout by e to the minus kt, I get my expression for v as g on k, 1 minus e to the minus k on t. And I've now completed question part b.
In this part of the question, we are solving this same differential equation, dv to t equals g minus kv, not as a linear differential equation as we did in part b, but as a separable differential equation. Can you separate the variables? I encourage you to pause the video right now and rewrite this equation in its separable form. How did you go? Well, the trick here is to divide throughout by g minus kv. So on the left-hand side, I'll have 1 over g minus kv times dv to t equals 1. Here is my function with respect to v, and on the right I have a function with respect to t, namely 1. What do I do now? Well, I'm going to integrate both sides with respect to t. I'm going to do this in the same line. I've left myself a little bit of space here for a dt. So I now have this expression. I've done the same things to both sides, integrating with respect to t. And you'll see, of course, that the dt here cancels with this dt here. So I'm going to rewrite this as 1 over g minus kv dv equals the integral of 1 with respect to t. And now we'll go and integrate. The integral of this expression here is, of course, a log function. So it's minus 1 on k log g minus kv equals t plus c. And just like in the previous question, I'm going to evaluate my expression for c straight away using the initial conditions. The initial conditions are the same as for the previous question. When t is 0, v is 0. So substituting into this equation here, I get minus 1 on k log g equals c. Let's tidy things up. Remember that what we're trying to do is create an expression in terms of v. So I'm going to multiply throughout by minus k. Exponentiate both sides. And using my index laws, this expression on the right simply becomes ge to the minus kt. Finally, we can write kv equals g 1 minus e to the minus kt. And that allows me to write an expression for v as g on k 1 minus e to the minus kt. Which, of course, is exactly the same answer as we got in part b. For part D, we are asked to find the terminal or limiting velocity of the object. Just to recap, we've solved the linear equation and the separable equation, dv to t equals g minus kb, and we've achieved a solution that v equals g on k, 1 minus e to the minus kt. So to find the terminal velocity of this object, what I'm going to do is look at the behavior of v as t approaches infinity. As t approaches infinity, v approaches g on k, 1 minus, now as t gets very large here, e to the minus kt gets very small, it approaches 0. So we have velocity approaching g on k as t approaches infinity. It's good to write a conclusion. So the terminal velocity